Should we get back on with this? I think we better. Following on from the last video, I've now got this panel all sanded. So I've took all that paint off and that old primer, and I've exposed, now you can see all the scratches there and there, all the repairs that need doing. Also, there's this bit here, this crack that's gonna need plastic welding. Also another crack here, and there's probably gonna be another one somewhere, no doubt. So that's ready to be plastic welded. But I've actually gone and bought a new plastic welder kit to try as well. So this is my old plastic welder. It's just a push button type, so you push the button in, it heats up, you let it off, and it cools down. This is typically what I'd use most of the time for melting the plastic back together. So you just hold the button in, and away you go, it'd melt it back together. Also, there's various different bits to go in the end, if I can get one out. So there's different types of these, depending on what you're wanting to attach together. And you would just melt these into the crack, and that'd hold it together as well. Well, that's decided to pack up now for some reason. Things only last so long, I guess. So I know I've had to get a different one. So I've got this new plastic welder cranked up and she's ready to go. Just trying to squeeze that crack together. Ah, yeah, she's keen. Put a mask on in a minute. Well, that's done a real good job of that. I've had to put the fan on here because it absolutely stinks, all that melted plastic. But I'm happy with the way that that's turned out. That tool works really well. It's probably better than the old one, to be honest. Anyway, I've got some of this metal gauze to go on next. So I'm just going to put that on the back to strengthen it up. Last thing I want to do is just put some of this super strong glue on the back, just on that edge really, just to be sure. So this is just a really strong two-pack plastic glue, and it's strong as hell. Do that won't take long to go off. That glue's now gone off on the back, so it's fairly solid. Next job is to get some filler in some of these scratches and the repair. So I've got some of this bumper repair. It's like a plastic filler, and obviously it's made by Noval, so I don't mind Noval, not bad products. Funnily enough, it didn't come with a spreader. But I had one anyway. As you can imagine, I've got plenty of these kicking about. So I'm just going to mix a bit of this up and start skimming some of the scratches and where I've done the repairs. So I'll put a bit of that on there, give it a mix, see what it looks like. Put a bit more on. Don't want too much, don't want too little. Probably do a little bit more than that. It's hard to see with the colour of the filler. Give it a good mix. I'll start by putting a bit in here. Quite deep. So the difference with this filler to normal filler is that it's flexible. It's got a little bit more give in it. Move on to our repair. Some scratches on here. So repair on the bottom. That I did. It's nice this fillet goes in well. Bit left, and I'm just going to put it on the back just to finish off. When I put the wadding on, it'll put a bit of strength in it and tidy it up. So that's our repairs so far. I'll wait for that filler to go off and then I'll give it a rub down. So while I was waiting for that glue to go off on that TZR panel, I just jumped onto this DT125R chain sprocket cover, slightly engine casing on the left hand side. It needed priming, so I jumped onto this and I've just given this a bit of high build prime for the repairs that I did on it, ready to give it a flat off and get it painted for the bike. For those of you that are new to the channel and you're wondering what that engine casing's off, it is off this DT125R project. So this is another project that I'm running on the channel. If you're interested in this, have a look through my videos. And I'm sure you'll find some videos on this project. Back to the TZR panel. So this can now be knocked back, this filler. I'm just going to use the DA to knock the top of it off. So I've knocked that down with the DA, now I'm going to finish it off by hand with a block. So I'm just doing that lightly, and I'm letting the sandpaper do the work. I'm not pressing on at all. I'm just letting that grit take it down. Thank you. Right, so I finished sanding the panel and I finished it off in a 180 and then down to a 240 grade. I've done inside the back there, just made that a bit tidier. I'll prime that up just to hide the repair a bit. I'll probably put some, like a sound deadening pad or something in there anyway, to make it look a bit better. So the next job is to prime the panel. And I just so happened to have some primer already mixed in the gun. But before I prime it, what I'm going to do is give it a quick rub over with a tack rag, and then I'm going to put a plastic primer on it first. So I've already blown it off. This is just to get any bits off on the edges and things. Get in there. For that. So this is the important side. I'm just going to use an aerosol plastic primer, Noval again. Let's go. Well, obviously that's in primer now. So I've just been in the house and I've got changed. I thought I'd best come out and have a look at it and see what it's like. And I noticed there's possibly a crack under there. So sometimes you can get hairline cracks and you don't always see them. They can just appear, or they happen when you're working on them or whatever, for whatever reason. But there's possibly a crack under there. It could be a scratch, but it might be a crack. But there's nothing I can do about it now. So that's something that I'm going to have to take a look at next week. So all I can do now really is, well, fuck off in the house and have a can of Stella, because it is Friday. Well, obviously that's in primer now. So I've just been in the house and I've got changed. I thought I'd best come out and have a look at it and see what it's like. And I noticed there's possibly a crack under there. So sometimes you can get hairline cracks and you don't always see them. They can just appear, or they happen when you're working on them or whatever, for whatever reason. But there's possibly a crack under there. It could be a scratch, but it might be a crack. But there's nothing I can do about it now. So that's something that I'm going to have to take a look at next week. So all I can do now really is, well, fuck off in the house and have a can of Stella, because it is Friday.